Hello, Meg here from PMTVUK. Today we are down at the Roland Artist Centre at Metropolis Studios in London. I'm here with drum specialist at Roland, Mike. You are no stranger to our channel. We have seen you on before and it's lovely to see you again. And nice to get a chance to chat about some cool kits that we haven't featured much recently on the channel. And I wanted to talk a little bit about this VAD kit. Yep. So first off, before we get into some intricacies with this, what these kits can do, tell us a little bit about what this VAD kit is and what it can offer.
So this is the VAD-706 kit. First off, it comes in four different finishes. So here we have the gloss natural. Mm. We also have the gloss ebony, the gloss cherry, and also the pearl white. The difference between the VAD-706 series and the VAD-5 series is firstly the finishes. So there are only four finishes available in the VAD-7 series, and in the 5 series there's just the one finish. Yeah. Also the bass drum in the VAD-706 series is a 22 inch, and in the VAD-5 series it's a 20 inch. The 7 series is coated in a finish, in a veneer finish, so you can see the wood grain to really show the quality, which is two layers of maple wood underneath the finish. And then in the VAD-5 series, then it's essentially just a wrap around a standard wood shell.
Yeah, and I'm right in thinking it was a sort of ebony black finish, wasn't it?
Yes.
The 5 series.
Midnight Sparkle.
That's it,
is the finish, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you can tell these have been designed for stage a lot because this has the look of a quite incredible maple.
Absolutely.
Looking high-end kit, which is exactly what you'd want if you had your kit on stage. So I can really see that in the design of these. Is it the stage and recording that these kits have been designed for?
100%. It's all about looks and feel with VAD. So you have a 10-inch rack tom, 12-inch rack tom, 14-inch floor tom. Pretty standard sizes that you get these days on an acoustic kit.
Yeah.
And the main thing also is that they are actually wood shells.
Mm, okay.
So they've been adapted by ourselves to make them less resonant. Because they are still electronic drum kits. So, you can put an acoustic head on the top of here, but it's not going to sound very good.
Right.
Because they're not designed as acoustic drums. They are electronic drums. But yeah, with any VAD kit, whether you go for a VAD 103, 307, or a 706, it is about looks and feel.
If you are using this on stage, what are some of the benefits to using an electric kit as someone who is a novice in this area? Why would you take this one out on the road, per se, rather than an acoustic kit of the same sort of sizes?
So first point is volume control. There are a lot more venues these days, if you're in function band, wedding bands, that require the band to have an electronic drum kit. And VAD, especially, you don't compromise. So you can have an acoustic setup, you can have an acoustic feel with the volume control of a module. So whether you go for the TD50X on the VAD-706 or whether you go for the TD27 on the VAD-5 series, you have the volume control. On the TD50X, you have 10 direct outputs, which you can completely customize. So you can have your kick, your snare, your toms, down particular direct outputs, the overhead mic settings as well, all configurable in the TD50X module. If you go for the VAD-5 series, then you've still got your four direct outputs, so slightly less, but still the same power as you get from a VAD-706.
Wow. So I can imagine this is actually quite a game changer for sound engineers as well. at the front of house mixing live bands, because I know from experience, depending on the size of the room, drums can be a bit of a nightmare to get right on stage, especially for the other performers on stage. And most of the musical world is now using in-ear systems, and having that much control over the volume of a kit makes a lot of sense. I suppose as well with the module itself, it must give you a lot more scope for tweaking the sound, especially if you are a drummer that plays in lots of different genres, lots of different bands.
Absolutely.
There must be lots you can do on the module itself.
Yeah, I mean, the TD50X and the TD27 has a bank of 100 drum kits. Wow. So that's 100 set kits that you can customize yourself. You can use the presets, and the next layer down from that, then, you know, you can change your snare drum, you can change your rack toms, how deep they are. You can even change things like room sounds. So like you mentioned earlier, you know, particular rooms are quite hard to control. So for a marquee, for a wedding band, for example, they tend to be quite dead sounding. But on the TD50X, you have an ambience fader, so you can dial in as much or as little of the room sound that you've chosen. It's very similar on the TD27, but there are no faders on the TD27, so it's a small bit of menu diving for you to find that setting to turn it down or turn it up, whichever venue you're in. You know, we have sample import and layering on our modules now, right from the TD17 right up to TD50X, so you can import your own samples as well. So if it's a particular snare drum you like, or a particular bass drum sound you like, you can import those, combine them together, or just import them as sound sources themselves. So there's quite a bit of scope there for you to really customize your own sound.
Incredible. Sounds like you can have real creative control over the sound of your drums.
Absolutely.
Which is a lot of fun. And not just on stage, I imagine this will bode well in a recording studio as well. What's the experience like recording with these? I imagine, you can obviously get quite a lot from the module and the kit itself.
Absolutely. If we talk about the TD50X module, it gives you 32 channels of audio over USB cable. So that's everything individually. So your kick drum gets sent, snare drum gets sent individually, but also the direct outputs as well. So a scenario for that would be everything gets sent individually. And then if you have a particular overhead mic setting, you can assign that to come out of the direct output as a stereo pair. Same with the room sound as well, the room ambience and any effects that you have. So everything can be mixed separately. Yeah. And the same with the TD27. So the TD27 gives you 28 channels of audio, which again is exactly the same as TD50X, where you have individual drum. Each voice has its own individual channel out over USB, and then you have your direct outputs as well, which have their own independent individual output as well.
Oh, amazing. So a lot of scope for what you can do recording in a studio. And do you feel like you lose any of that sort of, I guess as a drummer, a lot of it is that natural ambience and thing. Do you lose any of that? Surely with the technology of what's in these now, you won't, I imagine.
Yeah, pretty much. You're really limited to what you lose, to be honest, because you can create your own sound in the module. The feel is here, and you know, we have realistic sized drums that we can use to trigger those particular sounds. And even the drums these days have, or the trigger systems these days have evolved so that we don't have to compromise our playing either. So for example, with the digital snare now, we don't need to go to the module to say we want to play acrostic. It, because it has electrostatic sensor built in, it recognizes that anyway.
Wow.
So just to demonstrate for you now, if I put my hand on the snare drum, that'll be playing acrostic sound, and then you take it away, that'd be playing a rim shot sound. Oh. So I can go from playing a cross stick sound to a rim shot sound without going to the module to turn it off, to turn it on, just by playing my natural playing style. And same with the ride cymbal. You can mute at a finger touch rather than have to choke the cymbals.
Yeah.
So it's a lot more realistic in terms of the feel under the stick and virtually no compromise from a playing point of view when you're recording.
It's quite incredible how much it's evolved over the last 10 years from the first electric kits that came out. It's definitely evolved with the players in mind.
Definitely.
Yeah, those were some of the questions I was wondering about. How much do you have sensitivity to your playing and how much can you tweak? I suppose the way I would relate to it is with piano.
Yeah.
And when I'm playing electric pianos now, you have so much control over the key touch and how softly you play. And I imagine that's going to be very important as a drummer.
Absolutely.
When you're playing. So it seems like that is all encompassed in these kits now.
Yeah, you know, just to reiterate that, you know, these heads are tunable, not acoustic wise, because they give off no real acoustic sound. But from a feel point of view, I can tighten this head up to make it more responsive under the stick, or I can slacken it off to make it less responsive under the stick and make me work.
Yeah.
But that doesn't affect the sound from the module. So I can control both aspects independently of each other. So I can control my feel here, and I can control my sound here, which is the best of both worlds, really.
Mm, yeah, that really is. Is there anything else to do with the module as well that I might not be aware of, that's sort of an added bonus to using this kit? I suppose you've probably run through the key elements, but any sort of hidden gems on there?
So there are quite a few hidden gems. Very, very niche, I say niche things, very helpful things really. Record things like recording direct to SD card. So, you know, you don't need your DAW in that sense. If your guitarist friend or piano friend sends you over a track, says, I want some drums on this, it's only in its early stages, but see what you can come up with. You fire over your piano track or your guitar track to SD card, pop it in the side, press the song and record, and then you can select whether you just record the drums on their own, you record the drums on the track, and then export it to the SD card, and there's your track, really,
so
you can mix and master it from there. There's a song player built in as well, which allows you to speed up and slow down tracks.
Oh, okay.
So you can really, you know, if you're learning a particular track for an exam piece, for example, you can pop your SD card in, slow it down, really nail that fill, really nail that groove, speed it up to full pace, or you can even speed it up further than its actual pace, so you can really, really get into the groove. There's a few hidden things.
Yeah. Really cool. Yeah, that's this whole kit is just definitely built with creativity, isn't it? And playing in mind. This sort of thing where obviously acoustic drums are fantastic, but setting up room mics, setting up your drum mics just to record down a demo for a guitar track, you know, this makes the whole process a lot easier. And
it's a bit more practical as well, because, you know, not everyone, like you say, has the space for 20 microphones around a drum kit. You know, you might have to set the drum mics up, yeah, and then pack them down because you have a gig on the weekend with something like this. There's no mics, mm-hmm, just one cable straight out into your DAW, and it gives you 32 channels of audio over USB. Mm. It's a lot easier and a lot more manageable for some people at least.
Yeah. And in terms of pack down, if you are gigging, then obviously, mm-hmm, I know how this works with an acoustic kit, but how are they relatively easy to get up and down? I mean, it's a big kit, so you're not going to expect it to be a super quick job, but I'd imagine just like an acoustic kit, is it relatively simple to get up and down?
Exactly like an acoustic kit, because they are essentially acoustic sizes. Yeah. I mean, 14-inch snare drum, 10-inch rack tom, they'll fit in any generic acoustic cases.
Yeah.
Same with the cymbals, they'll fit in cymbal cases. The only thing then is to transport your module and your cables. And again, such as, like you said earlier, the evolution of electronic drums becoming more prominent, you can quite easily find flight cases these days for specifically built for V-drums modules. Even soft cases are available these days. So it's a lot easier to transport those kind of elements these days, yeah.
And I guess you have the benefit then of, if it is quite a long travel to a gig, you're going to get your kit out and you've got the peace of mind that you don't need to sit and acoustically...
Exactly. Yeah.
Tune the kit.
Mic check.
Yeah,
sound check.
Yeah, that's it.
Right, okay, you know, feedback from other places. It's the kit sounds as it sounds. You know, the beauty of an electronic drum kit is the sound doesn't change unless you want it to change. So you can go from playing in a marquee to playing in a huge hall and the sound will stay the same. It's just if you want it to change, it can change.
You have control over that.
Exactly.
Yeah. I can really see why electronic drums are getting more and more popular. And we're just coming out of festival season, really, but I've seen so many more at the festivals I've been at this summer on the stages, so I can really see why.
Yeah.
In particular, I remember seeing a couple of years ago the Gorillaz, and they had both electric and acoustic kit on stage, and it sounded huge, really huge. So I can see the benefit. And even more so after hearing some of the other things you can do with the modules themselves. And the fact that they look like actual acoustic drum kits now, sort of everything you'd want as a drummer. Thank you so much for chatting to me about this kit today, Mike. And thank you for having us in the Roland room at Metropolis.
For coming.
No worries at all. It's an absolute pleasure. And I hope everyone watching has found this as useful as I have. If you have, then drop us a comment below. Let us know what kits you play, or if this is your dream kit, let us know in the comments. We'd love to know. I hope you've enjoyed. If you have, then hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. I've been Meg. This is Mike. Thank you so much for watching.